Right, now we're on.
We just start in the morning by Mark chuntering of like, I've got to do this, I've got to do that.
Well, you've got to stab so many buttons on all these guys, 9 different devices. And, oh yeah, it's live, but how does
Hello,
that work?
Everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Act normal. Act like...
Normal? Yeah. What's normal?
Well, it's pretty normal for us.
There isn't any normal anymore.
It's about as normal as it gets. So...
Happy Friday.
Yes, happy Friday to everybody.
I want to start by saying, I don't know if she's watching, but happy 50th birthday to Helen.
If you are watching. Cheers, Helen. Yeah, if you're tuned
in.
In fact,
happy birthday to all friends who've got birthdays, because it seems to be like birthday season.
It does, doesn't it?
Yes, and I'm not sure how exciting that is if you're in lockdown.
Weird birthday. Well, the other thing is also, it's World Malbec Day.
Well, we haven't got any of that.
No, you should send some round. We could put it in, teacups.
Yeah, no Malbec.
Okay.
Well, we haven't got Malbec, but we have.
Well.
If they are ready.
Well,
I was going to say we've got... We've got a guest who's just having slight.
We have a surprise guest.
Technical issues.
We have a surprise guest. There's so much. Do you know what? I'm going to go live just so you can see the equipment room. So today's surprise guest is, drum roll,
Ed Harcourt.
Hey!
Oh, I like an entrance, Ed. I think this might be the. The best backdrop yet, for sure.
Ed, if it was completely necessary, would you consider buying some keyboards?
No, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't see any keyboards in here. it's insane in your isolation.
Well, how are you, dear boy?
I'm. Oh, one second. This is going off. One second. I'm good. How are you?
We're pretty good, I think. We seem to have beamed in directly to some sort of wall. Hang on, flopping around.
I want to go to Ed's place because that looks completely intriguing.
It does.
Things are good. I'm putting up like a. It's actually nice because I hadn't really been playing live that much, and then weirdly I've been playing live. Well, not live, but doing like videos, you know, and sort of delving back into the last 20 years of my records and getting requests and being like, whoa, I haven't played that for like 15 years. So yeah, why not?
You know. Cool, excellent.
One of my go-to work tools is actually just to go to you on Spotify and just leave it playing all day.
Oh.
So that I actually get the whole collection.
There's, there's definitely some duff tracks in there, I'm afraid.
Well, I'm not saying I love all of them equally.
What's your worst track, Ed?
The really tough one. I have to be honest. About 20 years ago, when I released Maplewood, a couple of the songs from that I redid on Heavy Monsters. And
yeah.
And the version that we did, the rejig of Apple of My Eye, I was just like, when I listened to that compared to like, the lo-fi 4-track version, it just doesn't compare. And I just wish I could have gone back in time and, done that in a much sort of cooler.
Well, regardless, Here Be Monsters, it will remain one of my favourite albums of all time.
Oh, thank you. Well, I appreciate that. And, I'm actually, am trying to write the next record in between lots of other things. And weirdly, it's kind of harking back to that era. So
excellent.
Yeah. And then of course you got the band Luke Guru. You were out with Supergrass, weren't you?
Yeah, we were on tour with Supergrass just before the whole of this mess happened, and that was so much fun. And our first ever gig was Glasgow Barrowland, so we were kind of spoiled.
Wow, okay.
Our first ever London gig was Ali Pally, you know.
And who else is in that band?
Coral, yeah. And it was, quite weird because like the second night wasn't sold out, and I think a lot of people didn't turn up because of COVID-19.
I was a bit disappointed because I actually was lucky enough to go see Supergrass in Dublin, but you weren't supporting.
We weren't supporting. We couldn't make it work. It was kind of, a lot of it's self-funded or using. We had like a track that was used on a comedy zombie horror called Zomboat. It's ridiculous. It's based in Birmingham, and they basically try and escape from zombies on very slow moving barges. That's kind of the whole joke. It's actually funny. It's sort of barge is sort of moving really slowly. There's loads of zombies like walking along the banks of the canal. But our song Sleep Forever got used as the theme tune, and that kind of helped us sort of get started. And, you know, it was a really good thing. And we're just in the middle of doing the record, which I'm really excited about. It's just this glorious, epic, dark, loud beast. So,
excellent.
And it's great because it's actually, as a result of doing that, which is like that, an outlet that I've always had, because I've always been in love with playing kind of loud rock and roll. It means that actually the songs that I'm just doing for myself are much more kind of piano led and a bit more kind of.
Yeah.
Great to have that contrast. Who are you in the guru with? Because I remember it being a really intriguing combination of musicians.
Well, what happened was it's basically two of my best friends. It's Richard Jones, who's bass player in The Feeling, and he's married to Sophie Ellis Bextor. And then it's Cass Brown, who was in Gorillaz and The Census Things and De La Cota. And Cass, and we all kind of write the songs, and Cass and I kind of write a lot of the lyrics, and Rich is like the sort of foundation, like the pillar, and you know, he kind of, and Cass and I are the sort of the flighty, you know, divas in a way, and we kind of all lock horns in the most creative way. It's really exciting and fun, and it's just you know myself and my two mates, you know, in this studio. We've done everything in here, completely soundproof, and shut the door, and you know, 3 days later, we've got like 10 songs. You know?
And are you finding this lockdown to be artistically inspiring, or are all the songs consisting of one specific thing? Can I go outside? Yeah.
Well, it's weird, you know, because when I've been playing some of the older songs, you know, on Instagram or whatever, sometimes the lyrics really allude to the situation. It's really, I mean, but I think you could do that with anything. But artistically, yeah, I'm doing a lot of writing with other people just over the internet, where we're bouncing off each other, and I send music, they send back melodic ideas, then I tweak the lyrics, and then they send back more ideas, and it's actually really creative. There are moments where I just feel like I can't do anything at all, and yeah, I just want to wear a dressing gown and eat waffles.
Good.
I just be like, hey, it's 9 a.m. I might have a beer. Why not?
It's
lockdown equals airport rules. You know what I mean?
Well, it's World Malbec Day, so maybe a bottle of Malbec later.
Ooh, oh, look at the excitement!
My favourite.
Yeah, well, I've not got World Malbec in my cup today. I've got apple and cinnamon. What you got?
I've got coffee.
Have you got a cup of tea?
I don't. I'm more of a coffee person, as you can tell by my manic demeanour.
So, have you got a song for us, Ed?
I have got a song that I'm going to do for you, yeah.
Brilliant. Okay, well, if you want to get set up to do that,
we will leave you to it.
I'm going to do a song called Murmur in My Heart from Back Into the Woods.
Excellent.
Okay, we'll drop out and we'll come back afterwards.
Okay. She's the moon that floods the harbor. She is the siren on the rock. In the pale morning, you love her. But she'll be the lover in your heart. She's the street lamp in the alley. She is the killer in the dark. And when your eyes are feeling heavy, show me the murmur in your heart. She is the mirror that stays so bright. The strangest dream I've ever had. She's the buzz from my guitar.
lover in the heart. She's the night that stays so young. She is the sharp pain in your chest. She is the spring that's rarely sprung. She's the bird that flew the nest. She's the mist that stills the forest. She is the bed trap in your leg. And when she pulls you from the wreckage, just pretend that you are dead. She is the nurse with the loving gaze. The strangest dream I've ever had. She is a murmur in my heart. Oh, I'll take a lie detector test. Watch the needle scribble out the truth. I don't need a priest to tell her I'm possessed. I've got nothing left to prove.
I'm just going to take you.
Oh, upside down.
One second. I'm taking you to the piano.
Okay, and I'm just going to say that wasn't all right. That was awesome.
Oh, good. Oh, God.
Oh, a little tour of Ed's ceiling.
Well, this studio keeps on getting bigger and bigger.
Yeah, well, it's, there's the. I've got lots of. As you can see, these are Ralph Steadman prints that he gave me.
Oh wow.
And there's the original artwork for Furnaces, and then I've got the neon sign which says the wolf cabin, and then various kind of paintings. Another painting, really weird one that Ralph gave me of Disneyland, and then a couple of little bits. That painting up there is by John Langford from the Mekons. Bought that in New Jersey.
Wow.
Which is pretty cool. And then a couple of my own paintings. This one's called Everybody Be Cool, Frank's Here.
Okay.
Brilliant.
And then this one is called, I haven't got a name for this one yet, but it's a sort of prophet's mystery-style skull with a crown. It's really, I really am not a good, I'm really... My paintings look like a sort of, you know, I don't know, a sort of jail paintings, you know. Charles Bronson type.
But what an amazing creative space, Ed. Like, is this in your house or?
No. So basically what happened was about 3 years ago, just had to get out of London and put our house on the market and just wanted the kids to go to a better secondary school as well, and all of that stuff, and wanted cleaner air. And we looked for like 6 months. We saw about 30 houses, and then eventually found this place in Oxfordshire. What I needed was a studio at the back of the garden that I could build. So I built this whole thing from nothing.
Wow.
It was, you know, it took a few months, 3 months, and and had to get like planning permission and all this stuff and hire an architect. And and I just made sure that the place was completely soundproof. So I can basically, I can play, if I wanted to play Napalm Death at full volume at 4 a.m, I can.
Which seems like the kind of thing you might do, let's be honest.
It depends. It really depends. It depends. If it's tequila, if I've been drinking tequila, then I'll probably put on, you know, I don't know, something kind of quite lighthearted and happy. If it's whiskey, then
then it's the Napalm Death.
Napalm Death, for sure.
Yeah. Okay, so you've gone over to the piano. You got another song for us?
Yeah. Well, there's lots of different options. I mean, I could do. I was planning on maybe doing Furnace.
Honestly, I love both albums. I see somebody on the comments said, I love that Dionysus song,
yeah.
Which is obviously Furnaces, but that's quite an epic to perform.
Yeah, and you know what? I don't want to do that one because I haven't played it for so long and I don't want to mess it up because...
Ed, you know... you know,
practice that one. I can't just reel that one off for some reason.
You know, we're huge fans. You play what you think.
You play what you like to play and we'll just enjoy
we'll
that.
We'll just sit here all being... Right. Nice.
All right.
We're going to leave you to it again.
Okay.
Thank you.
I don't think we need Dionysus to be epic. That was pretty epic in itself.
Thank you.
I still
got the fire within me. Still got it, guys.
Oh, thank you.
You're doing live broadcasts from your own Facebook page? You got some shows coming up, or? You're going to do whatever.
He hasn't got a plan. Yet.
You know what? I don't know. I mean, it's just so open ended, isn't it? I'm after this, you know, God, people are just going to explode, aren't they, when this is over? They're just going to go totally. It's going to be like the end of a war or something.
I am. I'm definitely doing that.
I mean, I love, you know, getting a hug from my kids and my wife is like the best thing in the world. But I just want to like hug a random stranger or something. You know, anyone. I don't care. Someone different. Someone who smells different.
Well, I think we agree with Steve Lamack that we're all going out with Steve wearing inappropriate trousers to go and see the Anti-Nowhere League as soon as this is all over. So you should come
definitely.
To that.
Yeah. I think everyone's just going to throw, sartorially, they're going to throw caution to the wind.
Yeah.
I believe. And yeah. I mean, I did about a week ago, I was kind of like, oh, you know, maybe I'll just like wear a different suit every day. That'd be great. You know, and then I just can't be
talking. Sooner or later, just went to the dressing gown.
Don't be such a knob, really. just wear your pajamas all day like everyone else. Come on.
Right, Ed, listen, thank you for coming by.
And being on such excellent form for us.
Listen, really appreciate it.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it. And, you know, just in the future, just count me in whatever I can do as well to assist or help with the MVT, you know.
Yeah, of course, mate.
Thank you. And nice we look forward to seeing you in person sometime soon.
See you soon.
Cheers. Lots of love. Bye. Bye. Be safe.
So that was Ed Harcourt dropped by.
That was delightful and very funny.
I thought what was really good is we failed to fawn and fan all over him.
We didn't.
I mostly did. We should probably explain. We probably play Ed Harcourt in The Office more than almost anybody else.
Except Divine Comedy and Ben Foggs.
Yeah, Divine Comedy, Ben Foggs and Ed Harcourt, that'll be it for us.
Yeah.
So, listen, thank you all for joining in today. Lots and lots of you joining in today. It was fantastic. Lots of shares and everything. We'll be back tomorrow.
Yep, better get some work done now.
Yeah, better get some work done now. It's 11s.
Have a good Friday.
Got a special treat tomorrow. Saturday 11s is slightly different. All right. See ya. Bye.